material abuse. So we'll start with the science. I'll go through that real quick. Next slide. So the science building fit very well just north of the fence, and that what was an open lot. It was interesting if you go back to the original plans of some of the earlier development that was always cited to be a building site. So fairly unencumbered with utilities, not completely, as we found out. So this is a two-story building. It's basically 9 labs. 19 offices for faculty. There's also a couple of student gathering areas on each floor. Entrances to the building are off the east from the parking, and then the west off of the student hall. We also have included, if you go to the next floor, there is also a data center that's being migrated into this building. So there will also be some emergency generators that will be associated with this building as well to help power those in case of a power outage. If you move my back up one slide, I just wanted to bring up that we're also developing the space between the fence, which would be down at the south end of this slide, and our building as a pedestrian walkway, and also has nodes or areas in this floor, students will be able to gather outside on the front to provide shade and other areas for student activity. Next slide. And we have one more slide. So I'll show you a few of the images. This is looking at the southeast corner of the building. So this would be approaching from the parking lot. Next slide. This would be from the student wall side. Next slide. And then inside the building, trying to add a little light, a little color. Outside, we're trying to match and blend in with the campus, with the existing materials and colors. Inside, we're trying to add a little bit more light to the student spaces. Next slide. Would be at the end of the corridor, under the student gathering areas. They will have it at the ends of the corridors. Next slide, please. And this is just a typical one of the labs within this. I believe this is our chemistry lab. Next slide, please. So once we move in, the existing site where the science building is at, the existing science building, then it will be raised and we'll return that site to natural desert vegetation. So it will be improved and brought back to natural desert. Next slide, please. Okay, so this is moving over to the union site. Next slide. And again, once this building is moved in, you can see the red dotted outline. That is where the existing union is at. That building will be raised, and we'll bring that back to natural desert vegetation as well. Next slide. So this building is located on the south half of what was the green. We are basically what we're calling, we're right-sizing the green, making it, it's about, I think when we're measuring this, it's longer than a football field, not quite as wide as a football field. It will still house, you'll still be able to hold graduation there, and there's a natural advantage of the building is that there is a raised area which will be used as a stage when there's any kind of performances going on. That's just outside of the dining area. That can also be used for student gathering. And when there's good weather, just for dining, we'll have some tables outside. So the building itself is providing the new dining, a new Vicaro lounge, student organization offices. There are meeting rooms in this as well. A large meeting room that can be divided in half, similar to this, but it can hold up to about 190 people when it's set up as a banquet. It's a little over 400 people when it's set up and just strictly a lecture style without desks. There's also just to the very right of that, that's the new bookstore. And we are also moving public safety into this building as well, which is the blue and the lower left corner of this building. And of course, food service and kitchen will be part of this, and the the south side of the building, pretty much still just a service corridor for bringing food to the kitchen and heating compressions. Next slide, please. So these are just a few images of how this is going to look when we're all done. This is focusing on the big porch, which is along the north side, all along the green. Next slide, please. Again, this is more of the porch on the north side. This is just outside of the meeting room. So this will work as pre-function space for the meeting rooms and any other spillover that needs to happen, maybe even outside of the bookstore when there's registration going on. Next slide, please. And then this would be all the way over at the west end of the student dining area. This is where the dining is starting to spill out to some of the open spaces on that side. And then this lies inside of the Carol Lounge, the new student meeting space. Next slide. And then this would be a shot of the dining hall. Next slide. And there's also more of a private dining or executive dining room in there that could be used for gatherings where food service might be needed as well. I think that's it. If you have any questions about either of these buildings, I'll be glad to answer those.
Any questions?
Madam President, it might be a better question for you, but I know there was discussion while we were doing this construction that some of the students might be involved in a safe manner. Is that happening, or?
I'm looking to Kristen and she's nodding her head, so yes. And I know that the students have been able, again in the summer with the limited courses, been able to go and observe and watch and learn of what's happening with the construction.
The work with the DPR just observe.
Right. Understood. Okay, good. And the second one is, remind me again about abatement issues, provisions for waste management, asbestos, lead, those kind of things when you're raising the other buildings. Was that part of the proposal? And if so, any surprises so far?
Yeah, we've had an abatement company come through and survey both of the existing buildings and put together a report on their findings. We've allocated budget for that to be able to remediate those buildings prior to going through the full demolition. But as far as actually getting into the buildings, that would be after the new work, the new facilities are constructed, we'll move into the demolition phase, which is when we'll really go in and be able to do some destructive efforts and find out what we have there. So we won't really know exactly what we have until the very end, but we do have a survey conducted and we've allocated budget for that.
And there are no surprises on that report so far?
No.
Okay, thank you.
Madam President, one thought. Are you also in the disposal business several months down the road after you find something, or do you have another company plan to do the disposal?
Yeah, if they're, you know, for any of the hazardous material abatement type materials, there will be a company who's licensed and certified in abatement that will handle all of the disposal of that business.
Thanks.
So Austin will give you, there's one more presentation up there.
So I'm just going to run through, my name is Austin King, by the way, I'm with DBR Construction, I'm the project manager that's overseeing the construction vending facility. So just wanted to give a quick recap on kind of what we've done to date over the past 3+ months thus far on the project. Give a quick overview of the remaining schedule up until the project completion and ultimately the demolition and revegetation of the existing sites, and then just kind of hit on a few of the really key metrics that we track on the, you know, on the general construction project and where we're trending. So first step, so this is kind of where we've been today. So the first step in the process out here was going through and doing our tree salvage. We've had 21 trees between trees and cacti that we have salvaged on the existing sites that we're currently keeping in a temporary nursery here on the north side of the campus, and we'll be reinstating those once the new facilities are constructed. So this is just some imagery of that process and kind of the size of the trees and things like that that we're taking out. And the next slide will show you where the temp nursery is set up. So we've got the big trees boxed, the cacti kind of replanted the natural landscape there temporarily until the new facilities come online. So a lot of what we've done today, if you go and look at the sites, it still looks kind of just like dirt out there. So most of what we've done thus far is really installing a lot of the, all the necessities, all the main veins of the building, if you will. So our storm lines, our sewer lines, our water lines, all of those utilities that you need to hook up the buildings to the utilities and have them function once they're complete. So we've got just over 2,000 lineal foot of different types of utility service that are associated with each building. We're about 85% or so complete with that installation, so bulk of that underground utility work is completed. The next slide here shows the excavation and grading efforts, so that's moving around all the dirt, getting all the building pads up to the proper levels for the new facilities. So at the science site, that includes taking out a lot of material that we're using at the Union site to build up the pad over there. And to date, we've had about 450 plus trucks that have rolled through the campus. So roughly 10,000 tons of material that we've moved around. And this is kind of where we are. The stage we're in right now is the foundation stage. So that is putting in all the concrete foundations that'll support the building. Currently at the Union site, we have about 80% of the foundations already poured in place. And at the science site, we've got roughly 50-60% of that work complete. So making good progress. And like I said, it doesn't look like much, but there's been a lot of work put in place. The next slide will show you kind of an overview of the overall project schedule, so you can see, you know, where we are today in August, kind of in the middle throes of the foundation phase, moving into the structural phase. At the beginning of September, we'll start erecting structural steel. You'll really start to see kind of the shape of the building start to be formed at that point. You know, and then into the latter part of the year, we'll be putting on the exterior skin of the building. So really at that point is when you'll start to see the overall shape and size and feel of this space to start to come together. First of 2018 is when we're probably, you can see the kind of the stacking blocks there. There's a lot of things going on all at that time. So first of the year is probably the biggest crunch time for us on the project, where we've got exterior skin wrapping up. We're working on all the HVAC and plumbing and all those types of things, and at the same time starting all of the prettier stuff, the interior finishes that ultimately are what you'll see at the end of the day on the building. So we are tracking there for a substantial completion date, or when we'll be turning over the building to CAC, right towards the end of June or early July right there, so that there's time for everybody to move into the new facilities and get acclimated prior to the beginning of 2018. And then you'll see in the green box down below, that is the building demolition phase and then the landscape restoration. So there's really a kind of a 2.5 month window there once the new buildings are online that we'll take and demolish the old building, reinstate and revegetate all of the sites back to the game. And then some of the key metrics on the next slide will show you kind of the main three things we focus on the construction side: safety, budget, schedule. So today we've had over 10,000 work hours that have been performed on the project. Zero incidents, zero injuries, and even down to first aid. We haven't even had to treat anybody for a cut or a bruise or a wound at this point. So very safe. And so far today, that's one of the top things that we strive for on the construction site. Budget-wise, we're tracking. There's been no surprises, as you know, we've talked about with the hazardous material abatement. There's been nothing like that that's popped up to put a wrinkle in our budget. And as far as scheduling goes, we are on time and tracking for our completion.
Great,
there's some
questions. I'm assuming from your report that there have been no significant impacts by weather on the process.
Well, we have had some weather impacts, but that is something that we account for in our schedule, knowing that, you know, we're out there digging trenches in monsoon season. We're bound to have that. Those monsoons are going to come hit us at some point. So we account for those things in our construction schedule so that when they do happen, we've already forecasted that into the schedule and we've got it accounted for.
Thank you.
So we, Dan Childers from our office has been doing construction administration out here. He's also a drone flyer, so he's taking quite a few videos out here. And well, we're going to try and document this throughout the course of the construction, so we'll be able to wrap this all the way up at the end. So if you want to go ahead and play it, this will show you today what you see.
Technology Academy. I think we have a PowerPoint that